Welcome to this new video tutorial. Here we are going to discuss the second online tool that can be used to explore Kubernetes, and that is the Katacoda playground. This is the best place for experimenting, exploring and learning Kubernetes and trying samples. As the first sign may appear some difficult for beginners, you will work through the tools so that I can explain you globally what is going on there in order to make maybe your life easier. So let's go to the website Katacoda Kubernetes Playgrounds. Here, look for that on Google, and then we are going to be presented with many options, and I think it should be this one. This from Katacoda calls this playground. We go there. Yeah, depending, sometimes you may have to log in or not, but here we are not logging in. If you are asked to log in, then you may have to sign up, but stay calm, it's free. However, we may have, like, there are other solutions depending if you are a vendors, trainers, teams or enterprise. They offer some paid services, but you could also use it to learn as we are doing now. But just note that whatever you are going that doing in right now in the lab would not be safe. For it to be safe, you have to pay, maybe to go for pay services. Yeah, that was just a note. Now you are presented with this page here, and here you can see the difficulty level, that's the beginner, and this is the estimated time that we may have to complete it. And here in Katacoda's, there are different sections. Different lessons are categorized into scenarios. So you have one scenario for doing a specific thing on Kubernetes, to learn, to explore a specific topic on Kubernetes. And as is mentioned here, you are going to have two nodes, one configured as a master node, and the second one, this is a master node. And here is the worker node. As you know, on Kubernetes, in order to get started, we need at least two nodes, one master node and one worker node. And here you see the launcher. What is happening here is that you already have, remember, this is tools allow you to explore, experiment, learn Kubernetes. Now, what do you do now is either write this command here to launch a cluster. You'll have to write these commands. This will allow us to create two nodes Kubernetes cluster using VVNet for networking. That's not the topic. So either you can write it directly, what I'm doing now. Launch .sh, or you can just come here and click on that one directly. Here you can see our Kubernetes is being created. Yeah, we have successfully created our Kubernetes. Now we can check using this kubectl commands. After installing Kubernetes, you should be able now to use this kubectl commands and get the cluster information. So the same thing we are going to do now, we are going to click there. You can see this cluster information. We have one master node running under this IP and ports. And then you have the Kubi DNS running. So that is it for this scenario. Of course, you may want to write any command, QVCL command that you want. You may play around. Even from now, you can start playing and all, like get notes. Here you have two notes, one master and ready. You can start like querying, checking stuff like get port. There's no resources, no port is there. You can start like getting services. We have only one service there. You can play, you can use different command, but that's not the topics. You can clear everything and then continue. Yeah, congratulations, here you have completed our scenario. You may rate it if you want, then get to the next scenario. And here you can see now there are different scenarios are there depending on what you want to do, like how to launch a single node cluster, how to launch a multi-node cluster using Kubi AGM, how to deploy containers using kubectls, and how to deploy container using YAMLs. And same thing goes to introduction to networking, creating ingress routings, and blah 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 blah. There are so many, almost all topics that you need to kick seal. Even the first step to become a certified Kubernetes application, you have everything for you. So we try to go as example to explore this first scenario here. Second scenario here, then still the difficulty level here is the beginner level, and the estimated time to complete it is around 10 to 15 minutes. Now we go next. Now we are presented now with one terminal here with Minikube installed in. Here is our dashboard, but we are not yet there. So you have here on top here, you will have four steps, and this is the first of four steps that you have in this scenario. So this scenario is split into four parts, and here is the first part. In the first part here, we start our Minikube. We check the version of our Minikube. Here this is the version 1.8.1, and this is the commit ID. Then we start, we can start the cluster by running the Minikube start commands below. So we want to start our cluster. What this one will do, that it will have, after doing this one, we'll have a Kubernetes cluster running in our online terminal. And as you know, Minikube start a virtual machine for us, and a Kubernetes is now running in that. So it's starting. It's launching here, Minikube's on Ubuntu 18. You have these two CPUs, memory, disk. Preparing our Kubernetes on Docker. Bam! Done, configuration is okay. Now you have kubectl configured to use Minikube. Next, we continue in the second part here. We check the version of our cluster, and then we try to see how many nodes do we have. We have only one node, which is the master node. We continue, and here we are going to see how to deploy a container. We can just clear the screen. Now to create our first container in our environment here, we are going to create, use this deployment commands. With first with our container names first deployment here, and the image is from Quota Coder. So what we do now is, if you just start like kubectl get port, you can see that there's no resource now found. Then let us create our first containers. And here you can see that one our deployment has been created. Now if we get the ports, now we can see one port is running. Now if you continue, we try now to expose this command is used now to expose our container that is running using the not port type on port 80. So we run there, it has been exposed. Then now after, as you know, the first time that we run a container is running, we deploy the first container is running inside our Docker, it's not exposed from the outside, we cannot get the applications here. We expose it now to make it visible to the outsides, and now we can now access our applications now and see, you can see using curl commands here, the host followed by the ports. This is what this not port is meant for. We have now the request of our applications running. So our application is running, and here you are getting the output from our application. Then we continue. In the last part here, we are going to enable the dashboard so that we can have, we can see the graphical user interface of our underlying Kubernetes system. So first we enable the dashboard, which is enabled, and then now we apply the configuration of the dashboard using the YAML file configurations here. Note that we are using kubectl apply. Apply because we already have an existing YAML there. So if it was not there, we could have used create. So we use apply now. And remember that this Kubernetes allow you to view your application in UI. In a UI, and this deployment dashboard has been available on port 30,000. It may take a while to start. Now to see the progress of our of the dashboard starting, watch the port starting with this comments here with the option W for watching. You can see everything is starting. Now, if we go to this link now, you can see bam, here is our dashboard. We have one, we have here one application here is running, that is the first deployment, and then we have one ports, bam is there. We have the replica, only one replica is there, and you have all the information are there. You may explore it to do whatever thing you may want. But here is our dashboard. Ja, that is it. And then if we continue, bam, we have completed our scenario. Congratulations. And we can move on and so on and so forth and explore whatever you want and start any other scenario, for example, how to deploy containers using CTL. So the same thing will happen here. And here we are asked to sign in before continuing. So feel free to sign in and continue. Feel free to sign in or sign up if you don't, if you already do not have the account. It is free. And continued explorations, very nice, very easy, and very helpful. So I hope this tutorial has been useful to you. Now you have at least some idea how to kickstart with Kubernetes and how to learn some of the interesting things without headache. Stay tuned for the next tutorial. Bye.